one of our vice presidents, and he carries the heavy load for these productions. We couldn't do it without him. I'm going to turn you over to Matt, let him talk a little bit about something, and then I'll come back and finish.
All right, thank you, Tom.
Hey, welcome everybody. Thank you so much for coming out and being here on such a special night. We at the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame are excited to be inducting such great talent and such good people in the community and people that have really excelled in music, but not only in music, but in the community and doing things for people around them as well. So we've got a great lineup, great talent. We want to tell you one more thing exciting. That right now we're in Omaha, but there's another town in Nebraska called Norfolk, Nebraska. And if those of you don't know, my dad's name is Jim Casey, and he was the founder of the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame. And it all started up in Norfolk, Nebraska. Not for any reason, but that's just where it started at. And as it's turned out, we have a permanent museum at the Elkhorn Valley Museum. It's the home of the Johnny Carson exhibit, and it's also the home of the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame. So, as you get a chance to plan out your next event, come up to Norfolk, Nebraska. Come up and say hi, and come check out this great exhibit that honors and pays tribute to all the people before us and all the people that have left their mark and their impact on the world through music. So without further ado, I'm going to pass the mic back over to Tom. Give yourself a drink, enjoy, and thank you so much for supporting the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame. Thank you.
Thank you, Matt. I want to thank some other people, too. Over here we have our sponsor tables. I want to thank American National Bank, the Boone Jaguar Companies, Sunny River Auto Sales, and Last Time Exteriors. They are our sponsors, and this event wouldn't happen without them. We got some other people that are advising directors of the Hall of Fame, and I'd like to take a minute to tell you who they are. One of them is Bob Ford. I think some of you know Bob. Bob also did a slide show that you're seeing. We want to thank Bob for that. Another one is George Manning. George Manning lives out in Gordon, Nebraska, and he represents the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame in the Western region. And he couldn't be with us tonight, but thank God for George. Is George here? I'm mistaken, George is here. Thank you, George. Also, we have another advising director. Her name is Angela Boone. She's the owner of the Boone Jaguar Companies, and she's our CPA. I would like to thank her. Also, we have a new nominee for the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame Advisory Board, and that's your own Johnny Ringgold. I'd also like to thank Rainbow Press that you all are printing. And I'd also like to thank Center Street Trophy, or Center Trophy. Center Trophy. They do all of the plaques for the ones that are done here. Also, I want to tell you, there's a guy making a video of tonight's event, and he sells copies of it, and he's going to record the music and the video of the entire event. His name's Randy Hardy, and he's running around somewhere. But he put an order for him on the tape. There you go. Oh, there he's waving at. We also have some commemorative t-shirts that lists all the inductees into the Hall of Fame this year. And they're available for $20 up there. See Maggie. And she'll do it. You'll also notice there's a couple empty tables. They're for some of the band members, and they will be coming. They're just not all here yet. So don't fret about that. All right, it's time to get going. I'm going to shut up. But first, I want to introduce our MC tonight. He's a three-time winner of the Nebraska Accordion Championship. He hosted Channel 7's Dance Stand years ago. He interviewed the Rolling Stones when they were in Omaha. He played with this review
in Las Vegas.
He's a house band at Anthony's at the Holiday Inn. And now he performs in retirement homes. And he also tries to keep classic rock going by booking Nostalgia Wednesdays at Bogey's West. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Johnny Ray Gomez.
Thank you, Tom. Thank you. I wrote four or five more things you could have said. Yeah, bro. Thanks. Thanks. Hi, folks. All right. You're with On the Thrift. Hi. I didn't know you were in a band. This is terrific. Good to have you here. I got to see who this is. Skip Henderson. No. Yeah, Skippy. Yeah. Okay, let's get this thing started. We have bios that are, you know, 7, 8, 9 minutes long. But we've had to cut them down, but you're going to know these folks. Before, I know you've been sitting a long time, folks. Would you do me a favor and have a great big round of applause for the people that are already in the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame? Let's give them a nice hand. Stand up, wave your hand. And so many people have told me, Johnny, what a beautiful venue. This is my first time here. What do you think of stocks and bonds? They've got a lineup. They've got Daybreak going to be here on October 12th, November 30th. Daybreak will be here. That's Tom and his band. And their lineup of entertainment is Wednesdays. Dance lessons from 8 to 9. And ages are from 21 to 80. That I got to see. Because I turn 80 in 2 weeks. What shot do I have, right? Friday, the same thing. Saturday, a DJ was country. That's right here at Stocks and Bonds. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, our first inductee into the 2023 Hall of Fame. He comes to us from South Omaha. He is in the Nebraska, that's right, the Nebraska Mexican-American Hall of Fame. He plays trumpet. And music has been a big part for 60 years of his life, playing gigs with polka bands like the Red Raven. Also, he joined the Don Juans at the house band for the Tropicana Club. Anybody remember the Tropicana Club? He played there for 10 years. Then along with Micah Citron, along with Paul Marquez Sr., and he formed the Mariachi San Juan Trio. They were the house band at Howard's Mexican Restaurant for 10 years. Howard's on South 13th. In Lincoln at Arturo's Mexican Restaurant for another 10 years. Now, he has got a new band called the Can Cans. Now, they're made up of these guys. The Can Cans are Joe, who is a Mexican, Miguel Citron, who is a Puerto Rican, and Pete Wetzel, who is an American. He's 85 years young and still wants to play more and more music. Ladies and gentlemen, he is beautiful wife, Mary Lynn Fahey. They have the GI Form Mexican Stage outdoors at the GI Form Mexican Restaurant, and they're raising money to have outdoor entertainment. And I got a feeling that a lot of the bands that you see here tonight will be performing. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a great big hand please for Joe Cabral.
Thank you, Johnny. Love you, Johnny.
kids on M Street. And I'm very honored to receive this Hall of Fame because, you know, thanks to all you people out there who put guys in there because it's music, you know. And I grew up with music since I was, my dad was a musician. Saw that ball play for a dollar and 19 shots. And anyway, first of all, it's not because of me. My wife is because I'm a parent. That's my honor. Mary, stand up, Mary, where are you at? Mary. Yeah. I love you, Mary. And my beautiful family, I have four kids, and I give them all mints of blessings. Oh, wait. And anyway, Mary Lynn. Mary Lynn, are you here? Mary Lynn, I don't know if she's probably at the bar. There she is, waving. I love you, baby. Mary Lynn. And I have a son, Terry, who's a Coast Guard policeman, newbie. Where's he at, Terry? Are you somewhere? Anyway, I love you, Bear. And then I have a son who's on vacation in Virginia. So I hope he comes back. And my son, Joe, I think a lot of people know Joe. He's got a band called Iguanas. Joe, Iguanas. He come in from New Orleans, you know. And you know what? I have a lot of people I got to thank. So just a minute, let me get my list out here. I don't know how much time we got. Let me get my list. Okay, hold my list, everybody. Okay, I love you. No, just kidding. No, but Johnny, I do want to say, I started playing music in the Boca Badges on Illinois, the bars. And every good musician plays in the bars. But I have one, my guest here, Jimmy Curry. Can you stand up, Jimmy? Jimmy Curry. Well, I put an ad, we put an ad in the paper, because I'm a hard man and I love it, a sax, or a trumpet something. And Jimmy shows up down the GI Forum, and he sees four Mexicans, he says, well, God. He's 17 years old, from Pittsburgh. I says, well, you're here, he says, I'm here about mission for you guys. I said, well, we play primarily Mexican music, we do a couple of rock and roll. He says, well, I put a piece of sheet music in front of him, and I can't read too good either. So I played it once, it was a loud. Yeah, I played it, then he played it. Trambo. So I said, hey, we're going to Lincoln this weekend. You want to go? I love you. So I drove, and the next week his dad calls up. I'm really like, there's two guys in my that he wants to join your band. So we went over and met his dad. He says, you guys. And we've been playing. Jimmy's been playing with us. He's 74 years old now. So do the math. You know, Jimmy's a rocker. He's a Boots Randall, played with the 70 Funnies, Open Up Express, all the good bands around town. And then the other guy, so I kind of stopped playing music. He says we got tacos? What was that? We're selling? Oh, okay. Anyway, my last story, we were going to... I was going to retire, but then we played a convention at the GI Forum, and I went into this Puerto Rican, Miguel Cintron. And he says, I'm a musician. I said, oh, great. Everybody says you're a musician. Anyway, I said, come on over to the house, have a beer. And a shot of tequila. Okay, here he comes. He's a canary. So I told Mary, I says, I'm going to start this mariachi dance. I says, you're crazy. I says, so we started, and Mary named the band because Miguel's from Puerto Rico, the Mariachi San Juan. And we're still not playing a lot anymore, but like Johnny says, we started a band called the Can-Cans, a Mexican, a Puerto Rican, and an American. And yesterday we played at Shooting Town, where the strip town downtown. And we are going. Anyway, I love you. I'm honored. And I can't tell you so much I'm honored. But a lot of my friends are here, and I can't name them all because they're mad at me. But I do love you. My family loves you. And thank you for supporting music. And Johnny Ray, thank you.
Joe, without further ado, get back up here. Welcome to the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame, Joe. Right now, we're going to show slides of Joe and Mary's wedding. No, we don't have them lining up. Ladies and gentlemen, our next inductee, his musical journey, his name is Bill Wakefield. At North High School, they call him Willie Wakefield. And now he is Dr. Bill Wakefield. Ladies and gentlemen, he appeared on the Ted Mack Show with a group. It was called the Crazy Cats. He joined a great band out of Iowa, the Berry Brothers, who were inducted in 1972, I believe, into the Iowa Music Hall of Fame. He's a drummer, a percussionist. This gentleman, you know him. He was one of the youngest ever to be in the Omaha Symphony and played there for several years. So you know his talent, reading music, playing music. I had the privilege of working with Bill, and while Joe, Cohen, and I were going places during the day and night, Bill was studying and getting his doctorate degree. Thanks, Bill, for making us feel real good. He has a band, Random. It's a house band at the Holiday Inn, and he finished his PhD and began teaching at UNO. He was a house band at Rawson's, 20s, and Anthony's, played venues, and even now they're still doing weddings. Now, played the Summer College Orchestra at Peely Park with the Raptors, and even did a wedding in Las Vegas at the Hilton. 2010, he was inducted into the Iowa Rock and Roll Hall of Fame at the Berry Brothers. Ladies and gentlemen, listen to his lineup with his band, Random. Dana Leonard, Bob Adler, Dan Cervini, Bob Zagozda, and of course, the late, great Fred Scott, who just passed away, in fact, worked with him for many, many a year. Well, last month, after 49 years, Bill retired as a professor in the School of Criminology and Criminal Justice at UNO. And he and his band still hopes to perform many gigs to come. This is part of his musical journey today for his induction. And before we say that, we want to say that Bill, very generously, gave $1,000 to the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame. Here he is, Dr. Bill Wakefield. Thanks, John. I really appreciate it. Welcome, everybody. Good to see you. I promise you got a long afternoon ahead of you. I will not bore you, or I hope not to bore you, but that will not go on for a long time. But I did just want to take this opportunity to thank the Nebraska Hall of Fame for my selection. I was flattered, I was honored, and I really appreciate it. I'm so happy to be here tonight. Making music has been, as I said, part of my journey. I love making music. We can all enjoy music when you get a chance to make music with some of your friends. That's the highest form of music for me, being able to play with different bands in different areas. Like John said, I'm not going to go over the facts that he read. Yes, I just finished 49 years at UNO. So it was a great career. This means so much to me. The Music Hall of Fame. I just appreciate it. And just a quick thank you to my wife, Ellen. I know she's back there someplace. And the rest of my family, my goodness, if I named them all, we had, like you said, I didn't list that long. Yeah, the one son that followed me with music, Sean Wakefield, and he's a drummer in Dallas, Texas. And his son, Austin, they came up today, and they're here just to see this. But all of my family, I want to thank them so much for their support over the years. You guys are musicians, you know, couldn't do it without a supportive family. So once again, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Have a great afternoon. Thank you.
Well, Bill, it's not over with yet. You got to get back up here. And ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Bill to the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame. All right. Thank you so much for congratulations.
Yeah. Jump Kent, back there on. That was fun. That was super fun. So we're going to do one more song for you here. This is kind of a tune that's become a little bit of a showcase for us, a little bit of some of you might just end the career. But it's all set up and it's going to be the last song we're going to do. But two by Pink Floyd for you. Let's make some notes for Rick, all the staff, all the Nebraska Hall of Fame presidents and vice presidents, all the folks who were involved for putting on tonight's show. They've been at it for months. Get this stage room is ready to go. And I'm telling you, we were here during the sound check. You guys are in for some treats tonight because there's some fantastic bands coming up. We can't wait to hear them.
Yeah.
community friends. A great honor for a great band. Galen Greer, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations. Thank you. Mark Johnson. Thank you, Mark. We're going to get some pictures taken. We've got John Kent. Great drum player. John will be joining the band at the Juliet Club. Just kidding. Greg Beamer, ladies and gentlemen. Kurt Murray, ladies and gentlemen. Connor. Ladies and gentlemen, Scott White on the bridge. From Scott White and the Sound Company. Yeah. We just wanted to say thank you, everybody. And we want to especially thank the music fans for still supporting live music in this area. Thank you, guys. There's a lot of talented bands, a lot of talented musicians here tonight who can't do it without you guys looking for and supporting live music. We appreciate that. All these guys up here who do the Music Hall of Fame, guys like Johnny who put together events on Wednesday nights, they work their tails off to give us an opportunity to play and you guys have a chance to come out and support live music. Thank you so much. I'm going to throw one more little shout out to my family, my wife, my boys. Appreciate you guys. Let me do what I do. It's not easy. Appreciate you guys putting down the floor when I'm gone. Also want to thank our techs, our support staff over the years, guys like Scott White. Guys have been doing this for a long time, made some very successful careers doing what they're doing. And a little shout out also to those guys that are not with us anymore. Roger Armstrong, Todd Schmitz, Larry Beckwith. Those guys, and Robin Floyd. We got some guys who were in part of the band for a long time that are not with us anymore. This is also for you guys. We appreciate it. Thank you so very much, you guys. So one more time, welcome to the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame on the Fritz. Thank you, guys. Okay, everybody. Everybody doing okay so far? Having a good time? Thanks for being here. My name is Glenn. We have to help out on this event. It's an honor and privilege for me. Representing our band for putting up with me all these crazy hours and that. Next up, I'd like to honor a guy who I've known since the 1900s. He's been a friend, a member, a teacher, a great guy. He's the mayor of Drum City for decades. We're going to introduce my friend Joe Vola. Once again, Joe Vola. Ladies and gentlemen, Joe Vola. Known around town as the mayor of Drum City. Joe operated Joe Vola's Drum City for decades, teaching and helping countless fans keep afloat by giving them terrific deals on equipment over the years. Joe has been a friend and mentor to musicians locally and nationally. He has played drums professionally for 75 years. From coast to coast, Joe has backed many top entertainers over the years, such as Sarah Vaughan, Bertha Kitt, Marilyn Mayne, Debbie Reynolds, Red Fox, Joey Bishop, Neil Diamond, Roy Rogers, and Dale Evans, with the sons of pioneers Roy Clark, George Kirby, jazz pianos of Lenny Tristano, and Barry Joe and Bennett produced and marketed his own concept called DC-1000. The most famous purchase of the DC-1000 drums was to Bibby Paul, drummer for power heavy metal band Pantera. Vinny loved these drums so much he recorded them on three of his albums. Joe has played all kinds of music from pop to Latin to jazz, always to support women's sections. Joe has been an inspiration to so many people over the years. It's a great honor to say thank you and welcome the mayor, Joe Boda, into the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame.
Music and theory lessons. Sonny Furniture was a strong force in the music industry, and now the Nebraska Musical Hall of Fame proudly inducts Mr. Sonny Furniture into the ever-growing musical family. Welcome, Sonny.
And accepting the Sonny Furniture in his plaque is Julie.
A short intermission, and for food right back over there, refreshments right over there, and we're going to get reset for our next entertainers, ladies and gentlemen, here at Stocks and Bonds for the 2023 Nebraska Music Hall of Fame Induction and Dance. Be right back.
There you go, you're in.
Following the success of that show, Billy created several internationally touring shows, including Rave On, The Buddy Holly Experience, and Yesterday and Today, the interactive Beatles Experience. Along with his bandmates and his brothers, Matthew and Ryan, Billy has become a legend in the Nebraska music scene and beyond, delivering unforgettable performances to sold-out audiences at some of the world's most iconic stages. With a unique blend of creativity and innovation, he has remained steadfast in his commitment to creating music that inspires and moves people, earning him numerous accolades and awards throughout his illustrious career as a performer, songwriter, and producer. As a result, Billy McQuiggan has left an indelible mark on audiences worldwide and his enduring legacy to continue to inspire generations to come. Billy has won countless awards for his work, including the Spotlight Award for the Best Actor in a Musical, and a Merritt Omaha Entertainment Arts Award for Yesterday and Today. Recipient of the Midlands Business Journal 40 Under 40 Award and a CPACS Alumni Award for Excellence in Public Service awarded by the facility and staff of the University of Nebraska and Omaha. Most recently, Billy opened the McQuiggan Arts Academy in Omaha, providing year-round theater, arts, and music programming to students of all ages. In addition, Billy started the Billy McQuiggan Scholarship, providing financial assistance to the student interested in pursuing a career in the arts. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Billy McQuiggan.
Confidential is not the Fritz. They were the none of you came to see me then.
the song that I wrote during 2020 when I had the most dangerous job in America, lead singer of a rock band. I was forced into retirement for about 6 months, so I opened my garage and recorded an album alone, all together. It doesn't make sense, does it? This song is about something that our dad used to say to us when we were kids, that if we stuck together, we could get anywhere and do anything. And it's so pathetic. I wish he was here tonight to send everybody, so I never gave this one to my dad. This one's called Together.
Oh,
get back up here.
Where the hell do you think you're going?
I want you to tell us about this guy right here.
That's my 15-year-old son, Kieran, right there. He's been rocking with us since he's about two.
All right. On behalf of the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame, Matt and I would really like to probably induct Billy McGuigan into the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame. Welcome, Billy. We gotta get his brothers in too. What's up with that? Would you guys like to hear him do one more song? Okay, you guys got it.
I just want to say thank you to everybody for making this possible, all the members of my bands over the years, and especially the fans. Thank you so very much. This shows you that you can fail all through your 20s and turn things around, everybody.
Thank you. 14, so. We're going to honor Buddy Graves right now. The late Buddy Graves. I'm very honored that they asked me to present. So, I would like to tell you a little about Buddy. He was a great jazz pianist. Buddy was a piano man. He began his early career as a young vaudeville performer. He was in vaudeville. But when you think about Buddy Graves, you think piano man. Buddy played for decades at Omaha clubs. And if you're old enough, let your mind take you back. The Beef Baron Room, the Lazy Leopard, the Panther Room, Anthony's, Nasser's, Ross's Steakhouse, the Spare Time, the Green Onion, Mr. Kelly's, Angie's Steakhouse, the Venice Inn, the Blue Room, and many more. In the late 1930s, he and another teenager danced professionally in vaudeville, and their act, which included tap dance and comedy, was called Buddy and Betty, Tops and Tap. Buddy then went on to serve in the U.S. Army, and when he returned, he taught himself to play piano, and then the legend began. He moved his family to Omaha in 1950, where he taught dance lessons with Gene Locken, and he formed a band, and they started playing in the Blue Room on 24th and Blake Street. Now this is from an Omaha World Herald article, and I'm going to quote what he said. All their cats played there. He once said, Duke Ellington's band, Count Basie, Buddy Rich. And he said, I had the opportunity to learn and play and work with the greatest. And he was one of the greatest. Buddy was diagnosed with throat cancer, which eventually led to the removal of his larynx. But he kept playing anyway. He played every weekend at the Touch until he was 94 years old. Musicians from around the area would wait for the opportunity to play with him. He had a natural talent of being able to transpose any song to any key on the spot. And singers loved to sit in as Buddy would play their special song in a key perfect for their voices. Buddy's repertoire included hundreds of songs. He really was a piano man. And this is to Buddy Graves and his family.
Please welcome Buddy Graves to the Hall of Fame.
Please for Bittersweet!
This is by Steely Dan.
Thank you. Whoever have her.
Hammer. They started and played for 40 years. They founded in Omaha, January 71. The original members of the band were Sam DeBase, guitars and vocals, keyboards, Larry Vallone, Pete Perez, Terry Brennan, and shortly thereafter, Bill McKeever joined the band on drums. In 73, Buck Phillips joined the band, replacing Pete on bass guitar for Betting on Football. In 1974, Fred Genovese joined the band. Joe Circo joined, replacing Bill on drums. Bitter Street was a group of guys who were committed to performing the highest level of musical professionalism. And folks, did you hear that they had the instruments down and the vocals up for this group? They did not overplay. They played to you folks with great harmonies. Give them a hand. This band practiced 3 to 4 hours a day, 4 to 5, 6 days a week, ladies and gentlemen, and their profession and livelihood, so they took it very seriously. It's time now to induct the Bittersweet Band. All right, Terry Brennan, Pete Perez, where's Pete? Here's Pete. Bill McKeever. Fred Genovese. Angela Inderocker. Matt Moore. Mark Donaldson. And Sam DeBase. Sam. And Larry Vallone. Please welcome to the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame. We got one more.
Hey, is Marge Phillips in the band, in the area here? Marge, are you here? Is that a no? We'll give her 1 second. We won't kick these guys off the stage yet. I'm going to think she didn't make it. Anyway, we're going to induct Buck Phillips into the Nebraska Music Hall of Fame again. Buck was a friend and a mentor to almost every musician in this place. He is also a member of the Iowa Musicians Hall of Fame, the South Dakota Musicians Hall of Fame, and give it up for Buck Phillips. You guys were fantastic. Let's hear it one more time. Bittersweet. All right, don't go anywhere. Everybody go to the bathroom, get a drink. We got the Confidentials coming up next.
thank our sponsors. Boonjan Wire Companies, Sunday River Auto Sales, American National Bank, and last time. Couldn't do this without you. And couldn't do this without the support. We've got one more band coming up, but before the Confidentials come and close the event, which is a very well-anticipated turnout, we'd like to conduct Shorty Best. Shorty Best was the Secretary Treasurer of the Omaha Musicians Union for years. He had been my adopted father, my dad passed away. He was a great mentor to many, many people. He was a real sweet guy, a talented drummer, and a wonderful person. So here to talk about Shorty is his son, Eshawn Best. So can we have a hand for Eshawn to talk about Shorty Best?
Indiana, Monticello, Indiana, in 1935.
11, he had a union card. And interestingly enough, in the mid to late 30s, there was the transition from ragtime music to sweet music. And while men, grown men, were paid $1 a day to dig a ditch, musicians, if they played the ragtime, got $2 a night, and if they played the new swing music, they got $4 a night. He said it was worth it to put the extra 2 beats into the song. So, moving to Indiana was very pivotal. There was a place called Indiana Beach, which was a resort and a ballroom where all the great bands played. Benny Goodman, with his drummer Gene Krupa, had played there, and he took a liking to Shardy, and was a great inspiration for him to continue playing music, make it his passion, and his profession. So, actually got to know Shorty. He got the name Shorty because he wasn't quite 5 foot tall. Okay, so alright, it's a little distracting. So I am very sorry for those who can't get this excitement, this kind of ecstatic moment when you are one with the phenomena of man's creativity. And if you are able to express it and enjoy it and be moved by it and move others by it, that is very special. That's what I mean by being a musician. Shorty was a friend to all of Omaha. For those who met him and knew him, they had a good friend. Let's hear it one more time. Shorty Bastion in the Nebraska Music Hall.
Discover or American Express.
So yes, you can order tonight, and you don't have to pay for it until you get it. On the form, you just put your name, your address, your phone number, your city and state zip code, email address, and you can also order by phone. Randy, CV Center. Randy is in the back doing all the work. Mary back there. Get ready for our next entertainer. Abraham is here tonight. Good to see you. Good to see you. Can I read your guys' bio, or are you... Is it any more time to get ready? Any more time? All right. The inductions first, ladies and gentlemen. Let me get out of this way. And, sorry. Come on. All right. We're going to do the inductions first. So, we need the induction crew. Where's Tom?
Mr. Curtis Pelzer. Davey Polson. Marcus Nunez. Mr. Chris Hacker. Hall of Famer. Derek Johnson on keys. Fantastic. Okay, out of class. Okay.
You guys are ready? Hey, you guys ready to get started? Hey, the time is coming. Let's go, fellas. Here we go. You ready, Mikey? We're out of room, man. Thank you. song. This is called Fiesta on the Floor.
much of the time. And we'd like to get the greatest dance floor moving. That's what Confidence you did. And you know, we appreciate what you guys did. This next song is reminiscent of those great times in the Ozone. Tony out there! This is one of those guys.
Thank you. Thank you.
congratulate all the Eagles coming to work. You know, Arnold Fritz was inducted today. But you know, when I was 18 years old playing baseball down in Iowa City in Corinna, Iowa, I had no clue I would ever even sing it again. But I wanted to preach to the guys on the baseball team to sing. So we came to a bar called Iowa Lounge, and Stan and Wayne used to have a band called The Touchables back then. And I said, hey, can I get on stage and sing with you? So I sang the band Stan and Wayne, the first time I ever sang. And on stage with a band, here we are tonight together, doing Duncan in the Rust Music Hall of Fame. So Stan and Wayne, Billy McWilliams, Bayer City, to all the inductees tonight, we want to thank you so much for being here. Thank you for the music and for all of the joy that you brought people all around the area. And we hope to continue to do so in the future. Thank you so much. We are the Continental Tour.
Get
Hey, I got an announcement to make tonight. I think you guys have been waiting. I've had a lot of questions for the last couple of years. But I don't know if you guys, anybody see the movie Blues Brothers? Well, I think the band is getting back together. So we're looking for the conference. So thank you so much for being here tonight. Let's keep one more song for them, Jay. Come on.
Thank you so much, everybody.
when you go out there, the next event you go to, whether you're a musician or you're just in the crowd, just remember one thing. Let's bring them joy. Thank you guys so much.